Well, g'day everyone. Thought I'd talk to you today about what hard drives I recommend for external hard drives for the M1 Max. I've had a lot of questions asked me about which ones I recommend, so I thought I'd take you through that today. Now, I am a photographer and also a videographer, so I do need sort of more high-ended drives due to the fact that I am sort of dragging over really large, say, movie files and things like that, and even, you know, high megapixel for photos as well. So I thought I'd talk to you about my whole setup. But first of all, let me talk about the internal hard drive, because the internal hard drive in these new Macs is nuts how fast it is. So if we switch over to here, now I'm not doing the test live because I'm using Wirecast to stream at the same time I'm doing this. So the drive may alter the numbers. So I've done a screen grab about roughly where it maxed went during the test. So the internal hard drive, if you look over here on the Mac, is really, really fast. The write speed got to 2909.7 and the read speed got to 2853. Sometimes it went a little bit above that. It occasionally went a little bit over 3000, both of these. It just depends where I grab the or stop the actual test. But you can see the interesting for me and people like me that do more high-ended video and things like that is that it tells you down the side whether it's capable of working with these different resolutions. And you'll notice that the internal disk goes way up to 2160 at 60p, and that will work with Cinema DNG and also 10-bit YUV422 and also ProRes 422HQ. ProRes is actually a little bit easier to edit than these other formats that you see on this side. It also gives you on the right-hand side there about how fast it will actually read and write at those resolutions. So this is a great tool, and you can check whether it's going to work with you. And I think that's absolutely brilliant. But the thing is, even though that is incredible, I don't really want to be using my internal hard drive unless I have to. Now, I've bought the 500 gigabyte hard drive because I want enough room there that I can have all of my apps on there and also allow it to, say, grab a swap file on there and still have plenty of room. They do say that you shouldn't fill over your hard drive really over 70% if it's an SSD because it will start to degrade. So that's the idea why it's often better to get a little bit more of your internal hard drive space than what you need. And in fact, I haven't even filled up anywhere near half yet, and I've loaded on all of my applications. So I've got plenty of room left there to grow over a period of time. I think I've only used 100 odd gigabytes actually. So that's that. Now, what I first tried was this Samsung. Now, I love the Samsung drives. I think they're amazing. This is the T5, and it really is quick. Now, this is the 500 gigabyte. Now, originally, I thought I'd be able to use this as the main drive, and I was getting, if you look at it, say, compared to the readout that I'm getting here, the write speed and the read speed was around about 450 with the 500 gigabyte. So yes, it's still quick, but it's nowhere near what I could use for high-ended sort of video and things like that. It would have really struggled if, I tried to use my Sony footage from the A7S III on that drive in Final Cut. So what I decided to do, because that was reading about 400 on the read and write, I decided to try a 1 gigabyte, because I did read that if you get the larger drives, the speed does improve. So that's what I did. I bought a gigabyte version of this. And this is the figure that I'm getting from the gigabyte version. So what I'm getting now is it has improved. So it was 400. Now it's gone up to 502. And it's also gone to 520. And that did give me a little bit more ability to do more high-ended type work down below when you're looking at these figures that are down below here. But I'm still was a little bit worried because I may one day want to, say, do something like, you know, 4K 60 or something like that. And you need to be sort of down these areas if you want to be able to do that, if I'm running with 10-bit. And this drive just won't let me do it, even if I'm going to do it at 25p, which is, you know, or 25 frames per second, which is just your normal video that you see online. So I thought I may have to try and upgrade this. So what I did was I've upgraded another drive to the T7. So this is the drive that I've just purchased this morning. And I'm surprised about how much they've improved this over the T5. Like I said, the T5 1 gigabyte drive was still pretty good in the fact that it was 504, and that was great as well. But like I said, I just need a little bit more of a boost. So what I did was I bought the T7, and the T7 gave me a readout here of 748.5 and 793. So it's a really decent step up if you're dealing at, say, from looking at the T5, which we're looking at here on this one. So if you're looking at the T5, we've gone from 504 and 520.7. If we're looking at it here, we've gone from 748 and 793. You'll also notice, too, that now it's given me the ability to run 30p at 2160. The only ones I miss out on are 10-bit, and I can't do 2160 50p or 60. But I will always really use 25 or 30, and then I slow my footage down. So this works for me with this drive for the way that I want to work. So what am I suggesting to people? If you are not a high-end user, the T5, 500 gigabytes will be ample, because you're getting around about that 400 megabits per second. That's ample for anything else that you would like to do, and it will run very, very well. If you're not a high-end video user, you could also buy the T5 1 terabyte, because remember I told you there was an improvement of 100 megabits per second on each of the read and the write from the T5 500 to the 1 terabyte version. So that's a decent step up, and probably if you got the 2 terabyte version, it probably would be even faster. So that's something that you have to think about as well. So if you're more just doing not quite high-end video editing, you know, you might want to be just using iMovie and things like that, well, then you might find that the T5 1 terabyte version is enough for you. But if you are like me and you're a professional photographer or a professional videographer or even a YouTuber that does high-end type video work, I'm recommending that you get the T7 because that gives you the ability, looking at that, to do up to 4K, and you can write up to 25 or 30p, which is all I need. I don't need anything faster than that. If I didn't need faster than that, I could run from the internal hard drive, which if you look here, it will run everything that's thrown at it at this stage. So, apart from probably maybe 8K, that's just not listed on these, but it certainly will run anything up to the 4K 60p. So let me know what you think. I just thought I'd share that with you. So what I've got at the moment, I've got two drives that are on this. I've got a T5, which is a backup drive, and I'm pulling things onto that. That's a 1 terabyte drive. My main working folder is the T7, and that's where I'm going to be putting my Final Cut files, things like that. So I won't be working off my hard drive. I'll be running off that, and also I'll be putting my Lightroom back up on there as well. Now, I have... The issue for me is I do have a RAID system, but I can't connect it at the moment because it's a Pegasus system, and the Mac drivers just aren't written for this at the moment. So at the moment, I'm still using my Mac Pro for my photo editing type stuff. Once that is running, they give me the driver, I'll move the RAID system over and run my Lightroom from that. So at the moment, it's forcing me to use two machines. Hey, if you have any questions about this, please leave the link, please leave it down below, and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. And I'll see you all in the next video. Bye for now.